Good day to you. You're welcome to RCCG New Covenant Parish's Open Heavens Daily Devotional. The Open Heavens Daily Devotional is written by our Father and the Lord, the General Overseer of Redeemed Christian Church of God, Pastor E. A. Adeboye. And I pray that as you join me today, God will bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. Today, 17th May 2021, we'll be looking at the topic, He Will Take You There. We'll be taking our memory verse from the book of Revelation chapter 3, verse 21, which says, To him that overcometh will I grant to sit with me in my throne, even as I am set down with my Father in his throne. We'll be taking our text from the book of John, chapter 14, from verses 1 to 3, which says, Let not your hearts be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. The ultimate goal of all genuine Christians is to make heaven. This is why Jesus died for mankind. Jesus said of himself in Luke chapter 19 verse 10, For the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which is lost. Only overcomers can make it to heaven. How then can you overcome? First, you must overcome all evil thoughts in your heart. Our Lord Jesus said in Revelation chapter 3 verse 20, Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come into him and sup with him and he with me. Proverbs 23 verse 26 also says, My son, give me thy heart and let thy eyes observe my ways. So we are looking at the fact that, the main reason why we are Christians, the main reason why we have accepted Jesus into our lives is because we want to make heaven. That's the ultimate goal. That with all the race we are running here on earth, with everything that we are doing in our service to God, prayers, reading of God's word, in our daily activities, we all hope and we are all aiming to actually make it to heaven. And that was what Jesus came to do, to redeem us to himself, so that where he is, which is heaven, we can also be there. So, only overcomers can make it to heaven. How can we be overcomers? How can we be winners? How can we be conquerors? The first is that we need to get rid of evil thoughts. We need to overcome evil thoughts. It's not that evil thoughts will not come, but we need to get rid of them, because every evil action actually starts from evil thoughts. It just doesn't come from anywhere. It comes from within man. So we need to take care of our hearts. We need to guard our hearts jealously. The Bible says we should guard our hearts diligently, because out of it are the issues of life. We need to guard our hearts. We need to watch our thoughts. The Bible also says that the heart of man is desperately wicked. So wickedness will constantly come. Evil thoughts will constantly come. We need to be on guard to chase it away. You know, there's a saying that you cannot stop a bird from trying to perch on your head, but at least it will try, but at least you can chase it away. So also evil thoughts. It will come, but let us be on the guard and let us chase away such evil thoughts. Let us observe our ways and let us watch our hearts. Beloved, when we allow Jesus Christ to come into our hearts, He will give us victory over all the thoughts that defile us and make us candidates of hell. You must allow Jesus into your heart, because naturally the heart of man is desperately wicked. Jeremiah chapter 17 verse 19. So we need to be on guard that we are not giving preeminence to evil thoughts, but rather that Jesus reigns supreme in our hearts. Like I said, if you leave your heart unguarded, if you leave your heart unattended to, you allow anything to foster and grow in your heart, the heart of man is naturally wicked. Even you may be amazed at the end of the day of what you are capable of doing. So let us watch our hearts. So what exactly is in the heart that makes it wicked? Mark 7, 21 to 23 provides the answer to this question, which says, from within, out of the heart of men, proceed evil thoughts, adulteries, fornications, murders, thefts, covetousness, wickedness, deceit, lasciviousness, an evil eye, blasphemy, pride, foolishness. All these evil things come from within and defile the man. So we can look at this, you know, flurry of evil things that the human heart is capable of, all been listed in Mark chapter 7 verse 21 to 23. So this is where we need to watch over our hearts. This is where we need to be on guard, so we don't let evil thoughts, wickedness, deceit, lies, blasphemy, hatred, envy, jealousy, bitterness, we don't let all those things permeate into our hearts. It is only those who overcome the above listed sins who will get the power to enter into heavenly bliss. You cannot do it by yourself. This is why you need Jesus, who can give you the power to live above sin. The power that overcomes sin is the power we need to make heaven, and Jesus is ready to give you if you are willing to forsake Satan, sin, and every form of wickedness. You must make conscious efforts to flee over all appearance of evil, like Joseph did in Potiphar's house. Beginning from now, your struggles with sin are over in Jesus' name. Amen. So, if you want to make it to heaven, you need to be able to overcome all these sins that arise from the heart. And we need power to do that. And it's that same power that will help us to overcome sin, that will help us to get to heaven. And Jesus is the giver of that power. So if you make up your mind today, if you have not given your life to Jesus before, you make up your mind today that you want to turn over your heart to Jesus. You want Jesus to come into your heart, because he says he's knocking at the door of our heart. If you open the door of our heart to him, he will come in and he will dine with us. He will live there. He will stay there permanently. And where Jesus is, any heart that Jesus is in, evil thoughts will be repelled. Evil thoughts will not, you know, find place to grow. So if you have not given your life to Jesus today, this is a perfectly good opportunity for you to give your life to Jesus. Ask Jesus to come into your heart, ask him to forgive you of all your sins, to help you to do away with evil thoughts, that the sins of the past he should forgive you, and then that you are accepting him and you are asking him to dwell in your heart permanently forever. And then he will come in and he will help you and give you the power to defeat sin. And if you are born again, let us make sure that we are fleeing all appearance of evil, just like Joseph in Potiphar's house. Don't let us toy with sin. Don't let us think we can handle it. Let us flee. Don't let us allow evil thoughts to fester. Once they come, let us cast them out. I pray God will help us in Jesus' name. The power of go and sin no more was given by Jesus to the woman caught in the act of adultery. In the act of adultery shall be yours. As was given by Jesus, the woman caught in the act of adultery shall be yours today, and you shall make heaven at last in the mighty name of Jesus. So the power of go and sin no more, as was given by Jesus, will be given to us by the special grace of God, and we will make heaven at last. You and I will see each other in heaven at the end in Jesus' name. Let's take our prayer point, which says, Father, please give me the power to overcome sin today. Make me a candidate of heavenly bliss in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord God Almighty, give me the power to overcome sin today. As many as are listening to me, Father, give them the power to overcome sin and make us all candidates of heaven today in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Thank you very much. I look forward to seeing you again tomorrow. God bless you.